Hi everyone, and welcome to a video on Earth, the space rock we call home. Breathtaking mountains and valleys, vast deserts, lush rainforests, winding rivers, beautiful lakes, seemingly endless oceans, and spectacular coral reefs are just some of the amazing physical features that we can observe on the surface of this planet Earth. But seeing Earth from space, well, that's a whole other ball game. One thing you can notice immediately is that Earth is, well, it's a rock. A space rock. A really big one. But it's not just any old space rock. It's our home. We live on Earth. Both you and I live here. And what's more cool, or what's more special about it, is that it's in what we refer to as the Goldilocks zone. That means it's not too close to the sun to be too hot, and it's not too far from the sun that it's too cold. Kind of like the story of Goldilocks and the Three Little Bears. It's just right. It's at the just right distance for life to thrive on this planet. Earth is spherical. That means it's round, like 3D round. So if you're a flat earther, I got bad news for you. You were proven wrong, like centuries ago. More than 70% of Earth's surface is covered with water, liquid water, which makes it really hard to get around on foot, unless you are in Pirates of the Caribbean and you can do impossible things. Like this. Or even this. Why do they even need a ship? I'm beginning to understand Jack Sparrow a lot more now. Like, really. Anyway, the Earth is a terrestrial planet, which means it's mostly made of rock. So if you remove all the liquid water from the surface of the Earth, especially all that ocean, you'll see that underneath the ocean is still rock. And that's because Earth is a rocky planet. It's a terrestrial planet, which means it's mostly made of rock. The Earth's rocky surface has different layers. On the outermost layer, it's the thinnest. And that's the layer that you and I both find ourselves living on. That layer is called the crust. And that consists of the continental crust, which is the crust that forms the continents, and the oceanic crust, which is the crust that's found underneath the ocean. That's like very far down. It's really hard to get to because of all the water. But if you go underneath the crust, we find another layer of Earth. We find the mantle. The mantle is a very thick layer, as you can see, way thicker than the crust. And the mantle is made up of liquid rock that we call magma. If we go further down or further into the center of the Earth, we find the core. The core is split into two parts. The outer core, which is made up of liquid metal, like liquid nickel and iron. And then if you go right to the center, we find the inner core, which is made also out of iron and nickel, except it's so pressured that it's actually solid, even though it's hotter than any of the other layers. The inner core is the same temperature as the surface of the sun. That's 5,500 degrees Celsius hot. Whew. Talk about a scorcher, am I right? By the way, all these layers are known as the lithosphere. We also get other types of spheres of Earth. We get the hydrosphere, which is made up of all the water on Earth. That is the ocean, the river, like rivers, lakes, and even the clouds. Are part of the hydrosphere. We also have the atmosphere, which is made up of all the gases in the air and in the sky of the Earth. That's known as the atmosphere. We also have the biosphere, which exists in all the other spheres. It basically talks about all the living things, because bio meaning life and sphere meaning, well, you know, sphere. So, yeah. Right, anyway. It's also important to know, another important thing about Earth is that it has this other space rock, what's smaller than it, following it around wherever it goes. That's called the moon. And Earth has only one moon, which is also known as its natural satellite. And the reason it's called a natural satellite is because just like a man-made satellite orbits or revolves around the planet, so does the moon. The moon revolves around Earth, much like how Earth revolves around the sun. Speaking of which, it's important to also note that Earth does two movements when it moves around the star. The first movement is called a rotation. This is when Earth spins on its axis. See this stick? It's not real, it's imaginary, but it really helps us understand Earth's position and its rotation as it moves around the star. It takes 24 hours for Earth to do one full rotation on its axis. We call this a day. By the way, before I continue, I just want to point out that Earth's rotation may be correct, but the moon's revolution, that's the speed at which the moon is moving around the planet, is way too fast in this particular video or this image, I mean, or in this GIF. So, ignore that moon's motion for now, because I think it's way too fast. It should take a few days before the moon rotates. Oh, sorry, it does a full revolution, not every day. Anyway, where were we? Right, Earth's movement. So a full rotation takes 24 hours, which is a day. And then we also have a revolution. So the time it takes for Earth to move from this position all the way around back to that position is called a revolution. For Earth to complete one revolution, it takes 365 1/4 days, which equals a standard year. I say a standard year because there's also something known as a leap year, which is where Earth has 366 days because there's one extra day in February because those quarters add up. So after 4 years, all those quarters add up to a whole day and Earth will get an extra day in that leap year. But in a standard year, it's 365 1/4 days. So just to reiterate, one rotation is 24 hours, which is a day. And one revolution is 365 1/4 days, and that's 1 year. So, all in all, Earth might be a space rock, but it's our space rock. And it's a space rock that we call our home. And we appreciate our home. We appreciate the Earth. I hope that you enjoyed that and you found it interesting. Never stop learning. Stay awesome. Till next time.